Hazardous materials in the workplace exist in a variety of physical states, such as solids, liquids, and gases. Depending on their original state and the type of processes they undergo, hazardous materials can be converted into other forms. These include dust, fumes, smoke, mist, or vapors. The first step to ensure safe chemical handling is knowing what substances you have on premises, how to use them correctly, and how they interact with each other. One of the tools available to help is WHMIS 2015. WHMIS stands for Workplace Hazardous Materials Information System. WHMIS is a Canada-wide system that provides workers with information and training on working with hazardous materials. In 2015, WHMIS aligned with GHS, Globally Harmonized System of Classification and Labeling of Chemicals. GHS is an international system that sets common rules for labels and safety data sheets around the world. Under WHMIS 2015, hazards fall under two hazard groups: physical hazards and health hazards. Within each hazard group, there are several hazard classes. For example, the physical hazard classes include flammable gases, and health hazard classes include serious eye damage, respiratory and skin sensitization. There are three essential components to WHMIS 2015 to protect workers from chemical hazards. One, product warning labels that come in containers. These labels include pictograms and other important information about specific hazardous materials. Two, safety data sheets that offer detailed information on hazardous materials as well as preventive and first aid measures. Three, employee education and training to teach the safe use, storage, and disposal of hazardous products. First, product warning labels. These alert workers that a product is potentially hazardous. The label warns of the major hazards of the product and the basic precautions that should be taken. There are three main label types. Supplier labels, which are placed on the containers by the supplier or manufacturer of the hazardous material. They provide a concise summary of information pertaining to that product. Workplace labels, usually handwritten, and are required when a hazardous product has been transferred from one container to another and will not be used immediately or may be left unattended. A workplace label is also required if the original supplier label is damaged or missing, or when your company produces a hazardous chemical. A faded or smudged label should be reported to a supervisor so it can be replaced promptly. Hazardous products in piping and process vessels also need to be identified by using product identifiers, labels, color coding, or placards. And lastly, laboratory labels or lab labels are required on certain lab samples based on criteria set up in the WHMIS 2015 regulation. They must remain on containers until they are empty and discarded. The second key component of WHMIS 2015 is a safety data sheet, or SDS. This is a document provided by the supplier of the product. The SDS provides more detailed information about the hazardous product than what is found on the label. Information like safe handling, storage, and emergency measures. Safety data sheets must be readily available to everyone in the workplace, close to where the hazardous products are present. Stored in a binder or electronically on a computer, available for every hazardous product in your workplace, That's covered by WHMIS 2015. The last essential component of WHMIS 2015 is employee education and training. Education and training play a critical role in protecting the safety of those working around hazardous materials. Ensuring your workers understand WHMIS 2015 pictograms, product warning labels, and safety data sheets will go a long way in creating a healthy, productive, and safe working environment. I'm Ilma Benu, and this has been your health and safety tip from Workplace Safety and Prevention Services. For more information, visit wsps.ca.